Hello friends, welcome back to Engineering Today, and it's been a while. We couldn't serve you with any updates and we really regret it, but we're back with some latest space updates again. We'll begin with SpaceX completing the last Falcon launch of the year 2021, then we'll move on to update where a Russian cosmonaut will take part in NASA's SpaceX Crew 5 mission, and we'll wrap up with a delay in SLS flight. Let's begin with SpaceX successfully completing their last Falcon launch of the year 2021. On December 21, 2021, SpaceX successfully carried out the CRS-24 mission, which was also the last Falcon launch of the year. At 5:07 a.m. Eastern Time, a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket lifted off from the Launch Complex 39A pad in Kennedy Space Center with an upgraded, flight-proven Cargo Dragon spacecraft attached atop the rocket. Other than being the final launch, this was also the 31st launch for SpaceX in this year, which is the maximum launch record for SpaceX within a year. SpaceX had debuted booster B-1069 for this 24th cargo resupply mission. SpaceX also achieved the milestone of landing a Falcon 9 booster for the 100th time. SpaceX tweeted, "Falcon 9's first stage is landed on the Just Read the Instructions drone ship, marking the 100th successful landing of an orbital-class rocket booster." Coincidentally, SpaceX marked their 100th landing of Falcon booster on the same date in which they marked their first ever Falcon 9 booster landing back in 2015, which was 6 years ago. On December 21st in 2015, SpaceX had gone to debut a major Falcon 9 upgrade and has also attempted to land a Falcon booster back on land for the first time ever. It was booster B-1019 which set SpaceX's first landing milestone. That Falcon 9 rocket was tasked with launching and deploying Orbcomm OG-2 communication satellites in orbit. After booster separation, B-1019 had successfully landed on the concrete landing pad with adequate landing burn during descent. It was the beginning of SpaceX in making histories, and over the next 6 years, Falcon 9 proved dominant in the space industry, with a huge potential to prove more dominant in the upcoming time. As a private space company, this is an outstanding performance from SpaceX. At present, landing of a Falcon 9 booster seems a routine event, but inclusion of any new booster in the lot, as in the recent inclusion of B-1069 booster, surely brings up some tension whether it will work as good as the earlier ones or not. But from the smooth ascent, separation, re-entry, and landing of new booster B-1069 on the drone ship, just read the instructions, during the CRS-24 mission, proves that the debut flight of B-1069 has fared as good as its predecessors. It's expected that B-1069 has a good potential for supporting 10 or more flights. SpaceX's landing of rockets has gained a good success rate, almost as well as Falcon 9 launch success rates. According to some reports, SpaceX has completed about 57 launches over the last 2 years, and out of those 57 launches, only 4 launches had missed landing. Sarah Walker, director of Dragon Mission Management at SpaceX, said about the landing milestone that 100 is a big milestone. "We're excited about that. And we're also excited to see how few new boosters we have to produce as the years go by and we develop our robust maintenance process on the fleet." The uncrewed Dragon 2 capsule, C-209, carried nearly 3,000 kilograms of experiments and other cargo, such as biomedical and material science investigations, for the CRS-24 mission. 2 more Earth science experiments are packed in the unpressurized trunk of Dragon. It will be installed on the exterior of the space station. This is the second flight for the C-209 capsule to the space station. Now, SpaceX Falcon 9 is preparing for their upcoming Axiom 1 private astronaut mission in 2022. Our next update is based on Russian cosmonaut Anna Kikina, who will be part of SpaceX's Crew 5 mission scheduled for late 2022. Joe Montalbano, NASA's International Space Station Program Manager, stated at the CRS-24 pre-launch briefing that NASA plans to launch a Russian cosmonaut aboard SpaceX's Crew 5 mission, which is planned to launch by September 2022. This announcement was first brought out by the Russian space agency, Roscosmos, on the 8th of December this year. And on the 20th of December 2021, NASA officials confirmed that both NASA and Roscosmos are concluding an agreement which would help to launch the first Russian cosmonaut on a SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft. Report says that since the advent of the Commercial Crew program, both NASA and Roscosmos were trying for such a type of agreement, which ultimately settled on the 20th of December. The Russian space agency stated that they've selected Anna Kikina, the only active female astronaut in Russia's cosmonaut team, as the cosmonaut who will take part in SpaceX's Crew 5 mission. Montalbano said, "The plan is to fly a cosmonaut on the Crew 5 mission next fall and then launch a NASA astronaut on an upcoming Soyuz mission. The agency is currently finalizing those plans through government agreements." According to a report, Anna Kikina will take part in the Crew 5 mission along with two NASA astronauts, Nicole Mann and Josh Quesada, and a Japanese astronaut, Koichi Wakata, to complete the four crew sets. Report says that both Mann and Quesada were first assigned to launch on Boeing's Starliner spacecraft on their first crewed mission, but a rise of anomaly in the valves of the Starliner capsule has led to a massive delay for the uncrewed flight test, resulting in NASA to reassign astronauts for Starliner to SpaceX Dragon capsule. So those NASA astronauts are now destined to launch on the SpaceX Crew 5 mission. Boeing's Starliner spacecraft first flew on an uncrewed mission 2 years ago, but was unable to reach the space station due to multiple software anomalies. In the recent second uncrewed test flight, several valves within the spacecraft's propulsion system had rusted and were jammed. They've found out that moisture mixture with the spacecraft's fuel caused the valves to stick shut. So engineers are working on those issues, and it's expected that the capsule will be ready by mid-2022. Our final update is based on a delay in the first SLS launch due to an anomaly with the engine controller. On the 14th of December 2021, NASA publicized that Space Launch System engineers had decided to replace the controller of the fourth engine of the core stage of the SLS as they're facing problems with the engine controller. Report says that one of the two terminated channels in the controller had failed to power up steadily during tests of the integrated vehicle at the Kennedy Space Center. As a result of this anomaly in one of the main engine computers, it's estimated that the first launch of the Space Launch System would be delayed to March 2022. The engine controller, which malfunctioned, had operated well during the Green Run test campaign of SLS core stage at the Stennis Space Center. That controller even worked well during the full-duration static fire test in March. So this sudden malfunction is quite unexpected. NASA stated that the root cause of this anomaly is yet to be identified. NASA said that replacing the engine controller will help returning the rocket to full functionality and redundancy while continuing to investigate and identify a root cause. NASA is developing a plan and updated schedule to replace the engine controller while continuing integrated testing and reviewing launch opportunities in March and April. On the 16th of December, Annette Hasbrook, Assistant Manager for Program Integration for NASA's Orion program, stated during the U.S. Chamber of Commerce's launch webinar that rollout of SLS for the wet dress rehearsal is scheduled for early next year. In the webinar, it was held that Artemis 1 would be scheduled to launch in February 2022. NASA had already stated before this anomaly event that the upcoming launch opportunities after the February window initiates from the 12th to the 27th of March and also from the 8th to the 23rd of April 2022. This recent issue now ultimately pushed the launch to the March launch window. Report says that NASA will roll out SLS to Launch Complex 39B for multiple tests, including a wet dress rehearsal test. According to some sources, SLS rollout was planned to take place by the end of December, But on the 10th of December, NASA stated that SLS was planning for a rollout in mid-January. It's quite probable that the recent anomaly may affect the rollout time.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.